Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching Weird News. Guys, today I am again with a new video on Raspberry Pi and OpenHive, and here we will see how to install OpenHiveN with Raspberry Pi to get started with home automation. This is my second video on OpenHive, and if you want to know how to install OpenHive to Windows PC, make sure to check my earlier video around that, for which I have given the link down below in the description. For those who are new to OpenHive, it's simply an open source home automation system developed using Java, and it lets you automate your home with support for tons of smart home devices. It has got a lot of cool features, and I will leave a link for that, so make sure to check that out. My earlier video was around installing OpenHive to Windows PC, and for that I used a PC with battery backup so it can take all the loads for that is actually required for my home automation system, because I have already got a lot of nodes, and battery backup helps when there is some power test and all, and it helps by not letting your system get into shutdown. But if you want to try out OpenHive or interested in trying to get started with home automation, you can certainly install this OpenHive into SBCs like Raspberry Pi or Pi64. In this video, we'll check with Raspberry Pi. With Raspberry Pi, we have two options, like we can install required packages on top of Raspbian OS, or we can straight away flash a pre-configured OS named as OpenHiveN to an SD card and edit it, which makes it a lot easier compared to installing everything manually. Coming to OpenHiveN, it is developed on top of Raspbian Lite and is in headless mode. So being said that, let's get started, guys. So guys, to start with this, let's first download the OpenHiveN OS for Raspberry Pi. To do that, get into the GitHub account of OpenHive, that is github.com/, and over here get into the repository that says OpenHiveN. Get into the releases to download the latest release. And over here, as you can see, the latest release is version 1.3 and released on June 17. This is the latest till now. So I'll get into the end of it, and you'll find the different downloads. So you'll find for like Raspberry Pi, the Pi64, and if you want to look into the source code, or you want to compile yourself for the platforms and all, you can get to the source code. So as I am using Raspberry Pi, I'll just click on this. And this is, as I said earlier, is the modified version of Raspbian Lite. So the download may take some time, and it is about around 200 MB. So let's wait till it gets complete. Now, after the download completes, you'll find a file something like OpenHiveN Raspbian, and you don't need to extract it if you are using Itcher, or if you are using Win32 Disk Imager, you need to extract this extract file. But over here, I'll just go with Itcher, and I'll drop a link down below in the description for Itcher as well as the GitHub repository for OpenHiveN. So make sure to check that out if you want to try out Itcher. Otherwise, if you are familiar with Win32 Disk Imager, you can simply extract this file to get the .img file that is being supported by Win32 Disk Imager. Now plug in your SD card to the PC, and over here on Itcher, select that XJET file, and you can see over here the XJET file is by default supported by Itcher, which is not in the case of Win32 Disk Imager. Anyway, you can go with anything or any software that you are interested in. Now with that, over here select the master OS device that you have connected, or there is the SD card. So make sure to select the appropriate SD card depending upon what you have plugged in. Now at the end, just hit the flash button. So this should take a while to get flashed. Click on yes. Okay. So let's just wait for it till it flash and verify the flashing. Now after the flashing completes, close it and unplug your SD card from the PC. Now let's plug the SD card to Raspberry Pi. connect one Ethernet cable and it should have internet connection, and let's power it up. We don't need any like HDMI display or keyboard or mouse, as it is already in headless mode. We don't need to configure by using mouse or display. It would start automatically. Now, one most important thing over is make sure you are having internet connection through the Ethernet port. Otherwise, the like configuration will not happen. You won't be able to run this OpenHAV and all, because at the beginning, when the like this Pi boots up for the first time, it configures or it downloads all the packages that is required for OpenHAV and all, and it configures it itself. So that's why it needs internet. So make sure you are having internet connection. So let's leave it for like 45 minutes or 1 hour, and it's going to take some time, and it might be up to 2 hours or something. So let's leave it, and after some time let's try to access it. So guys, finally my setup is complete, and it almost took 2 hours to set it up, and it may depend upon your internet speed. So let's quickly open up the graphical user interface or the web interface of OpenHAV. To do that, on your browser type in OpenHAVian pi.local, and to make it work you need to install some sort of MDNS service if you are using Windows. If you are onto Linux or Mac, it will you don't need actually any other software. So on Windows, for that you can install Bonzer Print Services by Apple. So in this video I am not going to show you, but I'll just drop a link down below to the Bonzer Print Services. It is a simple, you just need to download it and install it. No other configuration is required. Now on the browser, let's type in openhavpi.local:8080. This is the default, that is port, to bring up the web interface of OpenHAV. And as well, we'll see the initial setup, that is simple standard export.demo. So I'll go with the standard one. And if everything goes correctly, you'll find the web interface like this. Otherwise, you might your Pi might still be configuring it or something like that. So just wait till you get this openhavpi.local:8080 brings up your web interface. Now let's wait for a while till the initial setup for the web interface completes. Now after finally the like configuration completes, I'll find the as well paper UI, app panel and basic UI. So I'll not get into like this. If you want to check out this and what are the different things over here on different like packages and all, you can check my earlier video on this where I have shown like how to install it on Windows. So you can get into that. Now let's see what are the other things that gets installed along with OpenHAV onto the Raspberry Pi, or the, along with the OpenHAVian. So let's try to access the terminal of a Pi. So to do that, I can use PuTTY and use like OpenHAVian pi.local. Click on yes. And over here, by default username is OpenHAVian, and password is also same. Now over here you can find the terminal and look like this, and in meantime if you want to change the configuration or system configuration, you can do that by using the OpenHAVian config window. Config, I need to have root premises, oh sorry, it's not root. It is the like the configuration window, and I'll find like about OpenHAVian, if you want to update, if you want to upgrade, like if you want to like apply the improvement set we have upgraded and all, optional components or software that you want to install like log viewer, the open app generator, mosquito broker, Grafana, that is the data visualization tool, Node-RED, HomeGear, KNXT, then OneWeb for one-way communication and all, as we are having Raspberry Pi. So let's get back over here. Along with that, we have some system settings. Like if you want to change the host name, so if you want to access the serial port and all, Wi-Fi setup if you want to do. Then if you want to like plug in a USB flash drive, you can use the move root to USB and all. Back over here, you can have like backup and restore, manual flash setup and all those things. You can give it a try yourself. Let's exit. Now along with this, there are actual number of tools also get installed. Like let's say we want to like access the configurations and all, we can simply get into OpenHive ENVI, and over here we can access OpenHive conf folder, and over here same OpenHive EN password is, and this all are being done automatically. So if you are like installing yourself the OpenHive onto your Raspbian OS and all, you need to do like install Samba and all, do the file sharing and all things by yourself. But if you are using OpenHive EN, it does it like automatically. So over here in the edit like terminal, so we get syntax selector. But if you want to use Smart Home Designer along with this OpenHive EN, you just need to select for this particular folder from your Smart Home Designer. Again, for that you can check my earlier tutorial on this OpenHive. So I'll not get into that. These are different things over here. Just close it up. And you can have like OpenHive Share, OpenHive in. These are all logs and all. Now let's see if along with this OpenHive, what else we have like got by default. Let's see if we are having a Node-RED installation already, or we don't need to do it from the configuration menu. For that, I'll just type in OpenHive EN by dot local colon 9001 is the port for Node-RED, and again it is not installed by default, I suppose. So no worry, we can install it by using the OpenHive EN config window. So over here, get into system settings. Sorry, not system settings. Get into optional components, and we can install Node-RED and all. But again, I'll not get into that in this video. For that, we can check like in upcoming tutorials. So you can use Mosquito Broker and all, but again, let's leave it for now. Let's try another thing. Let's try to view the log and all, and that is on the port 1880. Let's see if we can. Again, this is also not installed, I suppose. But again, those can be done easily by simply using the OpenHive EN config window. So that's all for today, guys. I hope you have enjoyed this. If so, hit the thumbs up button and make sure to subscribe to this channel for upcoming videos around OpenHive and many home automation videos along with some tutorials and all. So see you next time in my next video. Till then, goodbye.